Hi everyone, welcome to Powershell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. In this video, let's continue the discussion on backdoors. Let's focus on source code of the backdoors rather than the demonstration in this video. So we will have a look at these three backdoors. The first one is the Gupt backdoor. Gupt means secret in my language. Gupt backdoor uses the names of SSIDs as communication channel to execute commands and scripts on a target. Add screen save backdoor uses image execution options for a Windows screensaver to execute PowerShell commands and scripts, and invoke ADS backdoor, which is written by Matt Nelson. It uses alternate data streams to hide our scripts, and those could be executed using various triggers like Windows Run Registry Key. So, instead of having a look at the demonstrations, let's quickly have a look at the source code of these backdoors. Note that in case of Add Screen Save backdoor, we are using PowerOperator to launch another backdoor from it. So, let's see. First of all, let's very quickly go through the source code of DNS, TXT Pwnage and HTTP backdoor, which I was unable to discuss in the previous video. I would like you to have a look at this thing. As you can see that we are using NS lookup again and again to retrieve instructions, and we are then just removing garbage from the response and reading the command or script. So this is when we read a command, and this is how we are retrieving a script. I want you to have a look at it, just because this is nothing complex or needs any expert level of PowerShell programming. In fact, these were one of my earliest PowerShell scripts, and that is the reason that they are still not verb noun naming convention compatible and contains some really ugly code. Same goes for HTTP backdoor, which uses the web client.download string, which we have been using so many times to check for commands and instructions. Note that we are using a separate exfiltration code block here in the end in DNS TXT Pwnage as well, and then the persistence option, which we have not discussed yet, contains separate code of itself. We will discuss persistence in a later video. Now let's move on to these three backdoors. Gupt backdoor is a small piece of code which uses a smart but small trick. You can see that it lists the available networks with the use of this netsh native command. And if the name of the network contains something like, for example, here the magic string is open. So if the network name is, let's say, open C, who am I? then because after the magic string, the backdoor encounters a C, it will execute the rest of the SSID name as a command. That is, if the SSID name is open C who am I, it will execute who am I on the target. And if after the magic string the character is U, it takes the rest of the URL as a part of the Google URL shortener. That is, it appends the rest of the SSID to this URL, downloads the payload and executes it. This one is necessary to execute scripts because I think SSID names could be only 32 characters long. Now add screen save backdoor checks, it uses the Windows screen saver, sets its debugger in the image file execution options registry key so that every time a screen saver timeout occurs or a user locks his machine, that is whenever a screen saver is triggered or payload is triggered as well, it uses couple of small tricks, like if screen saver is enabled, then its value is used. Otherwise, a screen saver from the default ones in Windows is used. Its timeout is checked. If it is not set, it is set. And here you can see that it sets our payload as debugger to the screen saver. Note that our payload in this case is reg value, which is the user provided payload plus the screen saver. That is, to appear legit, it executes the payload and then immediately launches the screen saver. So this is how it works. Now let's quickly move on to invoke ADS backdoor, which is a code by Matt Nelson. So the thing I would like you to have a look at in this is this thing. Note that how we are using command prompt to create alternate data streams on a target. So there are two alternate data streams created. One is our payload. Second one is a VB script wrapper around it so that there is no, otherwise there would be a window in front of the user which appears for a second. If we wrap it inside a VB code, that would not happen. So the second ADS makes our payload a bit stealthy, and then the call to VB script is written in the Windows run registry key, and using wscript.exe, the VB script, which is a wrapper, but the VB script inside the ADS, which is a wrapper around our PowerShell payload, is executed. So this is how these payloads work, these backdoors work. Now let's quickly see one of these in action. Let's see Gupt backdoor. So now we run Gupt with the magic string open and with verbose parameter. So now it is checking wireless networks for instructions. Now on my mobile, I will launch a portable Wi-Fi hotspot with the name OpenC who am I? So let me turn it on. So the hotspot is active now. Note that I have not provided any keys to the backdoor because it never connects to the hotspot. It just needs its name. Let's see if, okay, so it found a network, found a command, and is executing it. Let's stop it. Now we can always use the Google URL shortener thing to execute scripts as well. That you can do as an exercise of this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the information security community.